वेलकम क्लास नाइन टू द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ अ सिलेबस रोटेशन एंड रेवोल्यूशन. सो सी चिल्ड्रन, वी ऑल आर एक्वेंटेड विद दीज टर्म्स रोटेशन एंड रेवोल्यूशन एंड वी नो दैट रोटेशन इज़ द मोमेंट ऑफ द अर्थ अराउंड इट्स एक्सेस वंस इन एवरी 24 hours एंड रेवोल्यूशन इज़ द मोमेंट ऑफ द अर्थ around the sun once in every 365 and upon 4 days. So generally we are acquainted with these terms. Now see, the apparent movement of sun, moon and stars and other celestial or heavenly bodies, they gives an impression that all these bodies are moving while we are stationary. So actually it is not these celestial bodies or heavenly bodies which are moving, it is actually we, the earth, which is constantly on the move along with these two moments, rotation and revolution. And why don't we feel the rotation? Because we are also moving along with the earth at the same speed. So this is a common practice. We always say that the sun rises in the east and sun sets in the west, and during the midday it is at the zenith or on top of the heads. Actually the sun and the celestial bodies appear to be moving because of an account of the relativity of the motion between the sun and the earth. And so in fact all these heavenly bodies are constantly in motion, but they are held together. How are they held together in space? Because of the gravitational force of one with respect to the other. So these heavenly bodies are held together because of the gravitational force which exists between each one of them, which hold them together. So the earth's gravitational force holds the moon and the artificial satellites in their rotational pull path or the orbits. Now see the movement of the earth, as I have told you, rotation and evolution. And because in the whole of the solar system the earth is the only planet which has life on it, and so these movements, rotation and evolution, they affect the type of the plant, the animals which live on the earth. Now because of the varying amount of the heat of the sun which reaches the various part of the earth, because now why do we have different amount of heat received at different part of the earth? That is because the earth is spherical in shape, and secondly because of the inclination of the earth's axis, which is tilted at an angle of 66.5 degrees from the plane of ecliptic, or 23.5 degrees from the perpendicular to its normal. And so the amount of the heat varies from place to place, and because of that the temperature is the basis of climate and vegetation and the atmospheric changes which affect the variety of the life on the earth. Now see children, the rotation of the earth and the alternation of day and night with the help of this diagram. Of course I'll be sending you the pages across. If you look at this diagram, see the occurrence of day and night. The varying length of day and night is actually directly related to the rotation of the earth on its axis once in every 24 hours. See, while rotating, if you look at a globe, the model of a globe, and you rotate it around the axis, what do we find? Part of the globe, the earth, face the sun, which is facing the sun, because the earth is round like a ball. You can see in the diagram that part which is facing the sun will have day and the other side will be having night. And you can see the circle of illumination. The circle of illumination is that imaginary line which shows a clear demarcation between the phenomena of day and night on the earth. You can see this line joining the north and the south pole. This is known as the circle of illumination. Only that part of the earth which is receiving the rays of the sun is having day, whereas the other part is having night. That is because of the spherical shape of the earth. Now if we come to the period of rotation, the period of rotation time required is to, because the earth is like a sphere like a ball, it requires 360 degrees to cover one complete rotation, which the earth rotates from west to east. And the exact period is 23 hours 56 minutes 5.09 seconds. So approximately we say 24 hours. This period is termed as the sidereal day, the accurate time which the earth takes to complete one rotation around the around its axis. This is determined by the stars. Now, what is the effect of the speed of rotation? See, all the moving bodies on the Earth's surface, that is, what are the moving bodies on the surface of the Earth? Ocean currents and the winds, all are deflected toward the right in the North Hemisphere, left in the Southern Hemisphere. Why? Because of the Coriolis force, which is created because of the rotation of the Earth. This is called Ferrell's law of deflection. So see children, this Ferrell's law of deflection is actually based on the Coriolis effect, which was first described in 1835 by the French scientist by the name of Gustave Coriolis. According to his theory, all moving bodies like the oceans, moving bodies are like ocean currents, winds, they are in the North Hemisphere, they are deflected toward the right, and in the Southern Hemisphere, they are all deflected towards the left, which occurs due to the centrifugal force. So see children, if we come to the effect of rotation, rotation causes day and night as given in this diagram, and the variation in the temperature is also due to the rotation of the Earth. As part of the Earth receiving the rays of the sun which accumulate the heat during the day, the temperature is raised during the daytime, whereas during the night time this heat is given off and the temperature comes down. Now the apparent movement, not the real movement, which seems the apparent movement of the celestial bodies is the evidence of the rotation of the Earth. We say that the sun rises in the morning, sets in the evening. Of course, this is an illusion. It is not real. Actually, it appears so. The sun appears to be moving, rising or setting. Why? Because of the rotation of the Earth. Actually, the sun is stationary and it is we who are moving. Just like the trees, the houses which appear to move at a fast speed. If you are moving in a train, but it is they who are stationary and it is we who are moving in the train. So the rotation of the Earth from west to east determines the direction in which the sun, moon and the stars appear to rise and set. Another proof that the Earth rotates is if you drop a stone from a top of a multi-story building, from a high building, you see it will fall slightly toward the east. So the rotation of the Earth creates a centrifugal force, just like a spinning top. You all have played with a top. If you spin a top and the top is always bulging at the center, so this causes a bulge at the equator, and the alternate rise and fall of the ocean waves occurs twice in 24 hours due to rotation. There is a high tide and a low tide, which is caused due to the gravitational pull of the sun and moon at different time of the day, occurring at an interval of 12 hours 56 minutes, because the moon is also revolving around the sun in the same direction as the rotation of the Earth. So you've understood the Coriolis effect. See the diagram of the Coriolis effect. The actual path taken on the stationary Earth, in the Northern Hemisphere, you can see the wind is deflected to the right, and see the rotation direction of the Earth, rotation is from west to east, and in the Southern Hemisphere the deflection is toward the west. Here the North Pole is being depicted, here the South Pole. So the centrifugal force actually is a force which is directed away from the axis of rotation and appears to act in all rotating objects about an axis. That is why as the Earth rotates from about the axis, it experiences this centrifugal force which is directed away from its axis of rotation. So just like the example is a spinning top, which causes a bulge at the equator, and it balances that force which is responsible for the rotation and is known as centripetal force. So this much for rotation. If you come to revolution, the motion of the Earth along the elliptical orbit around the sun is approximately 365 and upon 4 days, or we say 365.25 days, known as revolution. And the period of revolution, or 1 year, is the time required for the Earth to complete one circle around the sun, and every 4 years this extra 1/4 day difference between the tropical year and the calendar year of 365 days is taken as one whole day. So this 365 1 upon 4 day, so this 1/4 of the day is taken as one whole day. And so we add this day in February every fourth year, or to a multiple of 4 years, we are able to account for the 1/4 of the year correct calendar with respect to the tropical year, and that fourth year is known as the leap year. What do you understand by perihelion and aphelion? Mean distance between the earth and the sun is about 150 million kilometers. And see, perihelion, peri means around or near, peri near, helion is the sun, near the sun. So on 3rd this January, when the distance between the earth and the sun is the least, or about 147 million kilometers, it is known as perihelion. On 4th July, the earth is at the farthest point from the sun, it is known as aphelion. Ap means away, helion again the sun, so away from the sun. So distance 152 million kilometers. These differences in distance do cause some difference in the amount of the energy which is received by the earth. See the diagram of perihelion and aphelion. Perihelion, the winter position on the earth, 147 million kilometers away from the sun, and aphelion is 152 million kilometer summer position on the earth. Now the speed of revolution we've already done. So the mean velocity of the speed of the earth is 107,000 km per hour or 30 km per second, but it varies according to the path of the orbit which is occupied, and velocity is greatest at the perihelion and least at the aphelion. So see children, if you observe the movement on the orbit from the space, the earth is traveling counterclockwise around the sun, anti-clockwise. So what is the inclination of the earth's axis? The earth rotates on the axis but is not at a right angle to the plane of revolution. If you look at this diagram, the inclination of the earth's axis and the plane of the orbit, it makes an angle of 66.5 degrees with the plane of ecliptic. See, 66.5 degrees from the plane of ecliptic, tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees from the line perpendicular to this plane. You can see the 23.5 degrees angle which it makes. And so children, these two points we have to keep in mind. The earth's axis keep at a fixed angle with the plane of ecliptic, therefore the axis always points to the same direction during the period of its revolution. Look at this diagram. Earth's axis always point toward the same direction no matter whatever is the position of the earth in relation to the sun while it is rotating or revolving around the sun. While it is rotating around its axis or revolving around the sun. Till here children, in my next video I'll complete the chapter and I'll be sending you the pictures of this chapter across. Till then, goodbye, keep safe.